wall of the nasal cavity and the lateral, no, and the floor of the nasal cavity.
No, this is nasal septum or medial wall of nasal cavity. And in this nasal septum, you can see the bones forming the nasal septum and the cartilage. So bones are vomer bone and perpendicular plate of ethmoid bone. And anteriorly, you can see the septal cartilage. Now, in this model also you can see the roof of the nasal cavity. Roof is formed by this bone. This is cribriform plate of ethmoid bone. And this part is nasal spine of frontal bone. And here posterior part is formed by the anterior part of body of sphenoid bone. So roof is formed by these three bones. This is cribriform plate of ethmoid bone. And this is nasal spine of frontal bone. And here is body of sphenoid bone. In this model you can see the floor. Floor is formed by hard palate. And hard palate is formed by palatine process of maxilla and horizontal plate of palatine bone. So these three boundaries you can see in this model. Now in this model you can see the lateral boundary of the nasal cavity are the structures and bones that form lateral wall of nasal cavity. And lateral wall of the nasal lateral wall of the nasal cavity is formed by these many bones, you can see. So from anterior to posterior, these bones are nasal bone. This yellow one is nasal bone, and behind the nasal bone we have frontal process of maxilla, and then we have lacrimal bone, and this is labyrinthine of ethmoid bone. Labyrinthine part of ethmoid bone form the superior concha and middle concha. Then we have inferior concha, and behind the inferior concha we have perpendicular plate of palatine bone, and most posterior part is formed by medial pterygoid plate. Okay. So the lateral wall is formed by these bones. This is nasal bone, and here is frontal process of maxilla, and here is lacrimal bone, and here is labyrinthine part of ethmoid bone having superior concha and middle concha. Then we have inferior concha and perpendicular plate of palatine bone and medial pterygoid plate. So these are the boundaries of the nasal cavity. This is roof, floor, medial wall or nasal septum, and the lateral wall or lateral boundary. Now we come on sinuses, paranasal air sinuses. You know, paranasal air sinuses are air-filled cavities in the bones surrounding the nose, lined by respiratory mucous membrane and opened by ostia in the lateral wall of the nose. Paranasal air sinuses, here is sphenoid sinus in the body of sphenoid bone, and we have frontal sinus in the frontal bone, and we have maxillary sinus in the body of maxilla, and I'm sure maxillary sinus
frontal.
And frontal sinus is here, frontal sinus is here, and sphenoid frontal sinus is here, sphenoid sinus is here, sphenoid sinus is here. Please call Abdul Budu.
What about this one? Okay.
In this we can see sphenoid air sinus and frontal sinus, yes. This is sphenoid sinus. This is sphenoid sinus, and this is frontal sinus. Frontal sinus here in the Abdul Wadu, I need a skull with maxillary sinus and ethmoid sinus. If we have a skull with maxillary sinus, you know, we can reflect the anterior wall and ethmoid sinuses.
Near okay. the anterior aspect, right?
Okay, okay. Now, in the lateral wall, there are concha and meatuses.
In this model, we have here frontal sinus, and we have sphenoid sinus here, and this is the roof of nasal cavity, and this is the floor of nasal cavity that is formed by palatine process of maxilla and horizontal plate of palatine bone. And this we can see concha and meatuses in lateral wall of the nose. The concha are superior concha, this is middle concha, and this is inferior concha. The space above the superior concha is sphenoethmoidal recess, and we have below the superior concha superior meatus, below the middle concha middle meatus, and below the inferior concha we have inferior meatus. This is anterior nasal aperture, and this is posterior nasal aperture or coina. The coina or posterior nasal aperture communicates the nose with the nasopharynx. So this is, here is the posterior nasal aperture, and here is anterior nasal aperture or nostril.
For the sinus, I think this one is good. That one.
Just for a bit. Okay. Now the other sinuses. You know, this is body of maxilla. So there is a sinus inside. You remove the anterior wall of body of maxilla from anterior surface. There is a cavity inside. This cavity is maxillary air sinus. Can you see a cavity in the body of maxilla? This is maxillary air sinus. And on this side, we have open here. This is maxillary air sinus. In the floor of the maxillary air sinus are projecting roots of the molars and premolars. So this is maxillary air sinus. And we have here frontal bone. If you remove the frontal bone anterior wall, there is a cavity inside. This is frontal air sinus. Cavity in the frontal bone is frontal air sinus and ethmoid sinuses. Actually, ethmoid sinuses are located inside the labyrinthine of ethmoid bone. And labyrinthine of ethmoid bone is lying between the lateral wall of nasal cavity and the medial wall of orbital cavity. So here is here. If you remove this medial wall of orbital cavity, you will enter into tiny air containing bony compartments called the ethmoid air sinuses or ethmoid cells. Anterior one are called the anterior ethmoid group or anterior ethmoidal sinus, and middle, and we have in the posterior part posterior ethmoidal sinuses. So ethmoidal sinuses are here between the nasal cavity and the orbital cavity in the labyrinth of ethmoid bone. Now the openings of the sinuses. In the inferior meatus of the nose, no sinus, paranasal sinus open, but what opens here? Nasolacrimal duct. And in the superior meatus opens only the sphenoid air sinus. This sphenoid air sinus, can you see the tip of the void? Sphenoid air sinus is opening in the
still.
sphenoid air sinus is opening in the superior meatus of the nose. This is sphenoid air sinus. So sphenoid air sinus is opening in superior meatus of the nose. And yes. Sphenoid myelitis. In the superior meatus, this. In superior meatus is opening posterior ethmoidal sinus. Yes, very good. So this is sphenoethmoidal recess. It is above the superior concha, is not superior meatus. Above the superior concha is sphenoethmoidal recess. And in the sphenoethmoidal recess is opening sphenoid sinus. And in the superior meatus here is opening posterior ethmoidal sinus. And all the other sinuses, they open in the middle meatus. Where in the middle meatus? If you see the middle meatus, you know, in the below the middle concha, there is a rounded bulge. This rounded bulge below the middle concha is ethmoidal bulla. In this ethmoidal bulla opens the middle ethmoidal sinus. Below the ethmoidal bulla, there is a semicircular slit that is called the hiatus semilunaris. In the hiatus semilunaris, open the maxillary sinus. And anterior to it, open the anterior sinus. This hiatus semilunaris leads upwards and forwards in the infundibulum, in which open the frontal sinus. So frontal sinus opens in the infundibulum of the middle meatus, and anterior ethmoidal sinus open in hiatus semilunaris, and maxillary sinus open in hiatus semilunaris, and ethmoidal sinus, middle ethmoidal sinus open in ethmoidal. What is ethmoidal bulla? It is a rounded bulge in the upper part of middle meatus, just below the middle concha. So these are the openings of meatuses, of paranasal sinuses in different meatuses of the nose. In this, you can something we can see, not other, all the things. Okay. So these are nose and paranasal air sinuses. Now nasopharynx. Nasopharynx is the upper part of pharynx that extends between skull base and level of.
Can we come here just for the rest of this?
Extends from skull base to the lower border of soft palate. So this part is nasopharynx. It is located behind the nasal cavity. Here we can see the lateral wall of nasopharynx. You know, anterior wall of nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx are not present, they are deficient. There is a wide gap, wide communication between anteriorly of the pharynx to the nose, mouth and larynx. So here we can see posterior wall and lateral wall of nasopharynx. In the lateral wall of nasopharynx, can you see this? You know, this opening is for Eustachian tube. This is opening of Eustachian tube, auditory tube, pharyngeal-tympanic tube. And this opening of auditory tube superiorly and posteriorly, there is an elevation called the tubal elevation. And behind the tubal elevation, we have a slit-like space that is called the pharyngeal recess or fossa of Rosenmüller. So this is fossa of Rosenmüller or pharyngeal recess, and we have tubal elevation, and we have opening of auditory tube, and we have aggregation of lymphoid follicles in the roof extending to the posterior wall of nasopharynx, that is pharyngeal tonsil.
So this is pharyngeal tonsil or adenoids. Actually, adenoids are the enlarged pharyngeal tonsils. So here we have pharyngeal tonsil. Here we have fossa of Rosenmüller, and here we have opening of Eustachian tube. So these are the main features in nasopharynx. And you know what is the nerve supply of nasopharynx? Yes? All the muscles of the pharynx are supplied by the vagus nerve except stylopharyngeus, that is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve, and sensory supply of the nasopharynx is maxillary nerve, but valicula is supplied by the vagus nerve. So this is the nasopharynx. Class. The end.
No larynx?
No larynx.
No.
No, larynx is not today. Larynx is next week.
Okay.
You have taken the lecture of the larynx?
Yes. Yes.
So now this lab is finished. Now if you want to ask some questions in larynx, no problem, you can ask if you have any questions in larynx. What is larynx? Larynx is formed a skeletal framework that is formed by three paired and three unpaired cartilages. They are connected at the joints. They moved by the muscles, lined by mucous membrane, and supplied by blood vessels. So do you know, you have to know the cartilages of the larynx, you have to know the joints of the larynx,
yes.
You have to know the muscles of the larynx, the nerve supply. You have to know the cavity of the laryngeal inlet that is formed by tip of epiglottis, eriepiglottic throat, arytenoid, interarytenoid. And then you have to know the inside of the larynx, what is vestibule, what is rima of glottis, what is ventricle, what is subglottic part, infraglottic part, what is ventricle. So you have to know the part of the cavity of the larynx, you have to know about mucous membrane, you have to know about the muscles, the nerve supply,
and
لا لا يا ابوي لا قطع خاص طيب تحضير شباب واحد اثنين